Chapter 6. Now the gates of Jericho were tightly shut because the people were afraid of the Israelites. No one was allowed to go in or out. But the Lord said to Joshua, I have given you Jericho, its king, and all its mighty warriors. Your entire army is to march around the city once a day for 6 days. 7 priests will walk ahead of the ark, each carrying a ram's horn. On the 7th day you are to march around the city 7 times with the priests blowing the horns. When you hear the priests give one long blast on the horns, have all the people give a mighty shout. Then the walls of the city will collapse and the people can charge straight into the city. So Joshua called together the priests and said,
Take up the Ark of the Covenant and assign 7 priests to walk in front of it, each carrying a ram's horn.
Then he gave orders to the people,
March around the city, and the armed men will lead the way in front of the Ark of the Lord.
After Joshua spoke to the people, the 7 priests with the ram's horns started marching in the presence of the Lord, blowing the horns as they marched. And the priests carrying the Ark of the Lord's covenant followed behind them. Armed guards marched both in front of the priests and behind the Ark, with the priests continually blowing the horns.
Do not shout. Do not even talk.
Joshua commanded,
Not a single word from any of you until I tell you to shout. Then shout!
So the Ark of the Lord was carried around the city once that day, and then everyone returned to spend the night in the camp. Joshua got up early the next morning, and the priests again carried the Ark of the Lord. The 7 priests with the ram's horns marched in front of the Ark of the Lord, blowing their horns. Armed guards marched both in front of the priests with the horns and behind the Ark of the Lord. All this time the priests were sounding their horns. On the 2nd day they marched around the city once and returned to the camp. They followed this pattern for 6 days. On the 7th day the Israelites got up at dawn and marched around the city as they had done before. But this time they went around the city 7 times. The 7th time around, as the priests sounded the long blast on their horns, Joshua commanded the people,
Shout! For the Lord has given you the city. The city and everything in it must be completely destroyed as an offering to the Lord. Only Rahab the prostitute and the others in her house will be spared, for she protected our spies. Do not take any of the things set apart for destruction, or you yourselves will be completely destroyed, and you will bring trouble on all Israel. Everything made from silver, gold, bronze or iron is sacred to the Lord and must be brought into his treasury.
When the people heard the sound of the horns, they shouted as loud as they could. Suddenly, the walls of Jericho collapsed. The Israelites charged straight into the city from every side and captured it. They completely destroyed everything in it. Men and women, young and old, cattle, sheep, donkeys, everything. Then Joshua said to the 2 spies,
Keep your promise. Go to the prostitute's house and bring her out, along with all her family.
The young men went in and brought out Rahab, her father, mother, brothers, and all the other relatives who were with her. They moved her whole family to a safe place near the camp of Israel. Then the Israelites burned the city and everything in it. Only the things made from silver, gold, bronze, or iron were kept for the treasury of the Lord's house. So Joshua spared Rahab the prostitute and her relatives who were with her in the house, because she had hidden the spies Joshua sent to Jericho. And she lives among the Israelites to this day. At that time Joshua invoked this curse.
May the curse of the Lord fall on anyone who tries to rebuild the city of Jericho. At the cost of his firstborn son, he will lay its foundation. At the cost of his youngest son, he will set up its gates.
So the Lord was with Joshua, and his name became famous throughout the land.